Hello, Windows Universe. Michael with the Windows Club bringing you another video that will not have a file missing error code. Now, most error messages a Windows user will face seems to be caused by a missing DLL file, or files. In this video, we will look at some general fixes that you can take. And don't worry, the article we link in the description will not become corrupted or missing. Now, DLL stands for Dynamic Link Libraries and are external parts of applications that run on Windows 7, 8, and 10, and most any other operating systems. Most apps are not complete in themselves and store code in different files. If there is a need for the code, then the needed file is loaded into the memory and used. Then that opens your operating system to problems if the software is not able to find the concerned DLL file, or if the DLL file is corrupted. You'll then receive the file as missing message. You have a couple possible solutions. Run the built-in file system checker tool, run the DISM repair, or reinstall the software that is causing the error, copy the DLL from another system, and restore it on your PC, download DLL files from a third party. The safest way to repair a DLL error is to run the system file checker that will replace missing or corrupted files. Now, Windows 10, let's open up a command prompt with admin privileges. Then type in, or you can copy and paste from the article we linked, SFC scan now, all one word, and hit enter. Now have a Snickers bar because this will take a while, 10-15 minutes. Once it is done, you should restart your computer. Now, if the problem still hasn't been resolved, try running the DISM. In a command prompt that has admin privileges, enter this, DISM/online/clean-up/restore-health. All is one word, and hit enter. Grab yourself another Snickers bar because this will also take a while. And once again, when it's done, restart your system after it's over. Now next, you could consider copying the DLL from another system that has a working file and then replacing it in the proper directory on your system. Now that might mean that you have to re-register the DLL. And there is also the possibility of finding the DLL from the software developer and downloading it from their website. Now, if you decide to go this route, make sure, and I can't emphasize enough, make sure that the DLL comes from the developer. This is because the DLL is most likely copyrighted, and if it is from a third-party site, you have no guarantee that it is the actual file and that it has not been altered or has malware embedded in it. Then there is what I call the nuclear option. Just uninstall and reinstall the software. And depending on your frame of mind, it might actually be the better option time-wise and headache-wise. It's just something you will have to decide as being worth your time and effort. Me, I usually just go nuclear. Have you ever encountered the dreaded DLL error? Wait, of course you have. Well, let us know how you dealt with it in the comments below. And for articles about this and thousands of other fixes, tips, tricks, hacks, how-tos, and the latest Windows 10 news, visit us at thewindowsclub.com. And if this video helped, give us a thumbs up and do not forget to smash that subscribe button to our channel, where we are always releasing new content aimed at making your digital life just a little bit easier. Thanks for watching and have a great day.